Okay, so today I'm taking you on a hike in a place called Plateau de Cossol. It's an area that is famous for having a lot of UFO sightings and paranormal activity. And like I did in the episode I shot in Sintra in Portugal, I wanted to take a film that has a weird effect and to recreate the ambience of the place. So that's why I chose to take the Lomochrome. Actually no, it's the Hyrochrome. So what we need now is a place where we can load this film in the shadow, because it's very sensible to daylight, more than normal film. So I think I just found a spot here. We're gonna load the camera and start shooting some film. For infrared color film, you need to block the blue light. The blue light. So to do that, you need a yellow filter. This will block the blue light and only absorb the UV light. So I think now I found a composition. We're gonna take our first image and see how it looks like. Wanna move my feet? The other thing you need to know is that the Hyrochrome is like slide film, so it has a very narrow exposure latitude and doesn't allow much exposure mistakes. So you have to be kind of careful when you measure the light. And since you use a filter, you need to compensate also, because the filter will decrease the amount of light that hit the film. So you need to add an extra stop for that. Usually with a yellow filter, it's about one stop. But if you use orange or red filter, which maybe we'll do later because I brought them as well, I will have to increase by 1.5 or 2 stop for the red filter, because it blocks a lot of light. So for now it's plain daylight. As you can see, there is more than enough light, so especially because it's a 400 ISO film, so I've got plenty and it's almost reaching the limit of my Rolleiflex here. Wanna move my feet. Now that I'm a bit rested and with a belly full, I can finally tell you more about this Hyrochrome film. So back in the days, this film was used by government and militaries. They were using this for aerial photography, mostly to monitor crops, forests, and the health of vegetation. And the military, they were using that to detect their enemies, I guess, because this film is able to detect a piece of camouflage in the middle of a forest, for example, or a field or whatever. So that was the main use of this film. The problem is that it's been discontinued. Since 2011, I think, there are no other company making infrared color film, apparently. The only infrared film you can find is black and white. I think this is still being made fresh, but for color, it's over since 2011. The batch I have is actually expired since 2011. So this is one of the last Hyrochrome batch made. Since it's been discontinued, it's very expensive. So first, I'd like to thank Dean from Hyrochrome Source for sending me this test rollover. I really appreciate, because when you check the price on eBay, for example, or even on his website, I'll put you on the link in the description, you can see that it's an expensive film, so you don't want to mess it up. That's why I'm going to give you a few more tips to make sure that you don't ruin the film, because it's very sensible and there are a few things you need to know before shooting a roll of infrared film. I mentioned already the yellow filter, but the next thing you need to know is the type of camera you're going to choose. today I took the Rolleiflex because this is the only medium format camera I have that is 100% mechanical. There is no electronic inside. And the problem with electronic is that it can damage the film. There are some infrared sensor. Mostly they can be found in the frame counter with camera with automatic advanced system, and also in the DX code reader. So if your camera is like a point and shoot, for example, is advancing film automatically, or if it's reading DX code, avoid using infrared film with this, because most likely the infrared sensor will fog the film and it will completely ruin the infrared effect. This brings us to the next point, which is how to process this film. Like I said, it's like a slide film, so it developed in E6 chemistry. You can also cross-process it in C41. I haven't tried that yet, and I'm not sure I will, because I only have one roll of this to try. For this time, I'm going to send it to my lab, Nation Photo. But if you send it to a lab, make sure that you ask them before if they can process infrared film. It's not only a question of chemistry, but it's also a question of how they process it. If they use a machine to process the slide film, most likely it will also ruin the film, because those machines have infrared sensor like in some cameras, and if the lab cannot switch off those sensors, it will also fog the film. So you need to make sure that either they can disable it, the sensor on the machine, or develop it manually like you would do, I think, with a Jobo or like a normal Patterson tank. So just to recap, here's what you need when you're shooting infrared color film. Like I said, you need a minimum a yellow filter. We can also use an orange or red filter. Then you need a camera that doesn't have any infrared sensor, so no automatic advanced lever or no DX code reader. And the last thing is you make sure that you can process it as it should. So the same, avoid mini labs, because they most likely will have a sensor that cannot be disabled. I'm not expert on that topic, so if some of you are, please let me know in the comment how this should be done. But the best way to do it is to develop it manually like this. There is no risk to ruin the film. So I think that's about it. Let me see. We have I think we have 9 pictures left. So let's continue our hike and hopefully get some nice shots. We'll be right back. That's all for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed this episode. I really can't wait to see the pictures, but yeah, I'm gonna get the film ready and send it to my friend of Nation Photo so they can take care of it. One more thing before you, while you wait for the film to be developed, if it's gonna take a long time, put it back in the fridge, but also put it back in the plastic canister. Like this, it will prevent any kind of infrared light that might leak in the film and damage your pictures. That's all for today. Oh yeah, and I also forgot, sorry, I said that I would try the orange and red filter, but I completely forgot, sorry about that. But I have another roll of infrared color film that I'm gonna try, probably in another environment, and hopefully I'll remember to try those filters as well. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next episode. Bye guys.